Ladies and gentlemen, hypothermia in children in 12 minutes. My name is Bernd Böttiger. I'm the chair of the Department of Anesthesiology and Intensive Care Medicine at the University Hospital in Cologne in Germany. And I had a little help in this presentation by one of my colleagues, Nicolas Leister. These are my conflicts of interest. I'm engaged in different national and international organizations, and I also have received some few fees for lectures. For me, hypothermia was always very refreshing because for the first time some years ago, we had something in our hands to save the brain after cardiac arrest and after hypoxic brain damage. And I would like to start with a case report to underline the power of hypothermia. Some 2 years ago, we received an alarm, child under ice in water, 6 years old. The firefighters were in place 20 minutes later, the water rescue 5 minutes later, and time in icy water was at least 25, if not 35 minutes. Then the child was resuscitated by our emergency physician and brought to the hospital under ongoing cardiopulmonary resuscitation. In the hospital, more than 1 hour after drowning, during ongoing CPR, we had a Glasgow coma scale of 3, wide pupils, apnoe, a temperature of 23 degrees Celsius, and asystole. We decided to prolong CPR for another 1.5 hour. And then we put him on ECMO, 6-year-old child, on ECMO at 34 degrees. So we increased the temperature slightly to 34 degrees and kept that for 72 hours. And after 2 further days of ventilation, the 6-year-old was extubated, and we were all very emotional about the outcome. And then he opened his eyes and said, "Can I please have some Nutella?" So hypothermia is very protective if it is initiated very early. And this is a simplified model of the mechanisms following ischemia. And the most important word here is simplified, because as you can see, it is highly complicated and it does not help to block one of these pathways. The nice thing is that hypothermia is blocking or positive influencing all these pathways. And there is a lot we can learn from hibernating animals that they use that during winter time. What do the chapters of the 2021 ERC guidelines say about temperature management in newborns and in children? And this is in the chapters newborn life support and pediatric life support. And we will start with newborn resuscitation and newborn post-resuscitation care. And what we can read here under the headline induced hypothermia: treatment should commence within 6 hours of birth. Targeted temperature between 33.5 and 34.5 degrees Celsius. Continue for 72 hours after birth and rewarm over at least 4 hours. And we have a lot of animal experimental studies. They are all showing early hypothermia is highly effective, as in the child that I presented at the beginning. And therefore, in this guideline, it is also stated animal data strongly suggests that the effectiveness of cooling is related to early intervention. And maybe early cooling is much more easy in newborns or in children than in adults, because there's not so much to cool. What do the ERC guidelines say about pediatric life support? Target temperature management in line with the ILCOR 2019 COSTAR update on target temperature management in children after return of spontaneous circulation. TTM should be used for children who achieve return of spontaneous circulation. Although potentially of benefit, lower goals for TTM, for example, 34 degrees Celsius, demand appropriate systems of pediatric neurocritical care and should only be used in settings where these are in place. Okay, that so far. This is the recommendation. And the duration may be between 24 and 72 hours in children. In newborns, we say 72 hours. We also have a Cochrane review on newborns. And what about outcome and the death and major disability in survivors? A very detailed Cochrane review, more than 80 pages. And you can see in summary, selective head cooling with mild systemic hypothermia resulted in a far better outcome when the newborns are cooled. And the same applies to whole body cooling. Significant, the bar is here on the left side, which means favors hypothermia, significant better outcomes with cooling. Study in the New England Journal, whole body hypothermia for neonates. Conclusions, whole body hypothermia reduces the risk of death or disability in infants with moderate or severe hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy. These are the temperature curves, cooling for 72 hours. In newborns, this is the outcome, primary outcome, death or moderate or severe disability. More than 200 children or newborns in both groups, and you can see a significant better primary outcome in the hypothermia group. This is here the Kaplan-Meier curve for the probability of survival, same picture. Next study, 72 hours therapeutic hypothermia. In pediatric, we are going to the pediatric situation. In pediatric out-of-hospital cardiac arrest. Here are the temperature curves. This is now out-of-hospital cardiac arrest, and here are the outcomes. You can see significantly improved one-month survival and also significant differences with regard to disability and disability scores in favor for therapeutic hypothermia. Another New England Journal study, therapeutic hypothermia after out-of-hospital cardiac arrest in children. Again, you have the temperature curves here. Temperature was lowered for 48 hours in this study, not 72 hours. Primary outcome, a little bit in favor of hypothermia, alive and death. You can see the differences here. Secondary outcomes, alive at 1 year, a little bit in favor for the hypothermia group, but all these differences have not been statistically significant. And if we are going to the all-cause mortality at 28 days, there was again a benefit in the hypothermia group, and this was not significant. It was at the margin to be significant, but it was not significant. So we cannot draw a final conclusion from this study, but there was a marked trend in favor of hypothermia. What is the summary that we can say from the newborn's perspective? In newborns, treatment should commence within 6 hours of birth, targeted temperature between 33.5 and 34.5 degrees Celsius, continue for 72 hours after birth and rewarm over at least 4 hours. This is for newborns. And for children, use targeted temperature management in line with the ILCOR COSTA update on target temperature management in children after return of spontaneous circulation. TTM should be used for children who achieve return of spontaneous circulation. Although potentially of benefit, lower goals for TTM demand appropriate systems of pediatric neurocritical care and should only be used in settings where these are in place, which is hopefully possible in many places in the world. We do not know whether 24 hours or 72 hours is better, and further studies are needed here. This is for children. And please don't forget, early cooling is the key. And early cooling can be reached in children much better and much earlier than in adults. That is probably also the reason why we have these strong signals from different studies that cooling and hypothermia and temperature management at lower temperatures is useful in newborns and in children. With this, I would like to thank you all very much for your attention.